How do I stop my neighbor from using my IP address? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Ask Leo is supported in large part by its patrons. Visit askleo.com/patron to find out how you can help and gain access to exclusive patron-only content as well as an ad-free experience on askleo.com. So let's get right into the question because it actually has what I will call a bit of a misunderstanding about how things worked. My neighbor used my IP address to send out emails. How does this work? Can I change my IP address? I have Googled this topic and the answers are very confusing. Honestly, it depends on how they got your IP address and in fact, whether it's really yours at all. There are a couple of things that could potentially be going on here. Let's look at each one. If they're actually, literally, using your IP address, then that implies they're on your network. They are on your local network using your internet connection. The most common way that happens is if they are close enough to connect to your Wi-Fi and your Wi-Fi happens to be open. In other words, it doesn't require a password. That way, yeah, they're sending email or just using the internet through your connection, through your ISP. And that's probably not something you want to have happen. I know that people do it on purpose, but it's after they've been asked and they are aware of the situation and they've actually given their neighbor permission to do so. Clearly, from the nature of your question, that's probably not the situation here. So how do you solve this? How do you fix this? Well, the quickest way to deal with this is to put a password on your Wi-Fi. Use a WPA2 or a WPA3 password so that in order to connect to your Wi-Fi, any machine, yours included, would have to supply this password to do so. That'll kick your neighbor off the network if you've been using an open Wi-Fi. If you were password protected, well, change the password because it's very likely that your neighbor somehow figured out what the password is. They can't sniff it. It's not that kind of security. It's not that easy to do, but somehow they got it. So change it. That's how you kick them off the Wi-Fi. Now, the other issue, of course, is what if they're not using Wi-Fi? Well, the only way, as I said, that they could be using your actual IP address is if they are on your actual network. If they're not using Wi-Fi, there's a cable somewhere. They're plugged into your router or something. I don't know how. It seems really unlikely because it seems like it would be really obvious that there was a cable running next door. But the point being, though, that if they're actually using your IP address, they are on your network. That's bad for a number of reasons, and you should be looking for ways to stop that. Wi-Fi is the most obvious, but if it's a cable, it's a cable. Now, there are some other explanations here. They all boil down to it not really being your IP address. First, IP addresses are confusing. Let's read them very, very carefully. And what's worse is that regardless of what IP address they're using, they're probably using the same ISP you are. In other words, if you're getting your internet connectivity from Comcast and that's who serves your network, maybe they are too. Point being then that the IP address range that is used to assign to individuals using an ISP may be similar. It's very possible that they have the same IP address as you do, with the exception of one digit being different. That's a different IP address. If you're not careful, it can look like the same, but you must very carefully look at the IP addresses that you're finding to see exactly what they are, and they must be digit for digit the same before you can claim it's your IP address. Where did you come up with this IP address? That actually leads to an interesting question. I don't know how you know they're sending email from your IP address. My assumption is that somebody got email, or maybe even you got email, and you're seeing that IP address in the headers, the headers of the email that we don't normally see. Be, again, very, very careful that you're looking at the right thing. especially if you got the email, your IP address is going to be in those headers if you received the email. It doesn't imply that they sent it from your IP address. It implies that you received it at your IP address. You get the idea, right? So be very, very careful that what you are seeing in those email headers is in fact the IP address they are sending from. My guess is, might not be. And finally, it's also very important to realize that at the consumer level, at the consumer ISP level, the residential ISP level, your IP address can change. It can change frequently, like once a day. It can change only once a month. It's unclear. It depends on the various different ISPs on how frequently they will change your IP address. Sometimes unplugging your router and plugging it back in again will get you a new IP address. Sometimes it won't. It depends entirely on the ISP. So I can't really give you instructions there on how to get a different IP address. In fact, if you do want to figure out how to get a different IP address from your ISP, you'll have to talk to them. They're the only ones that can tell you what their system will respond to do that. But it raises a very, very interesting point. Since IP addresses can change for both you and your neighbor, it is possible, not likely, but possible, that your IP address today could have been their IP address yesterday. In other words, they had it, their IP address changed, you had something else, your IP address changed to what they used to have. Like I said, it's statistically improbable, I'll call it, but it is certainly possible. So I hope that helps a little bit in understanding what kinds of things you need to be looking for. My money is on the open Wi-Fi hotspot, so definitely take a look at your Wi-Fi access and whether you've got that appropriately secure. For comments, for updates, for related links and more, visit askleo.com/3814. I'm Leo Notenboom. This is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.